Welcome to the fourth installment of Fish and Game State of Deer and Elk. My name is Rick Ward. I'm the State Wildlife Manager for the Department of Fish and Game, and today I'll be talking about big game season setting. The last three videos covered deer and elk populations, deer and elk surveys, and deer and elk survival. In this installment, I'll cover the big game season setting process, including how we use the information covered in the previous videos in setting seasons, and how you can get involved in the season setting process. All hunting and trapping seasons in Idaho are set every 2 years, except for migratory birds, which are set every year. Big game seasons are set in odd number years and include deer, elk, pronghorn, black bear, mountain lion, and wolf. But in this video, we're going to focus on deer and elk. So what is big game season setting? To put it simply, it's the decision process that results in the what, when, where, how, and who of big game seasons. What type of big game and how many, such as sex and bag limits? When hunting seasons open and when they close? Where the hunting season takes place? How big game is hunted, such as rifle, archery, or muzzleloader? And who's doing the big game hunting, such as youth-only hunts? There's a lot of moving parts in the season setting process, but we follow the same step-through process for setting all of Idaho's hunting seasons. It starts with identifying issues with existing hunts, as well as ideas about ways to improve hunting opportunity or the hunting experience. Those issues and ideas come from several different places, including from the hunting public, such as at big game check stations, encounters in the field, and at sporting group events. We also collect comments year-round from hunters that engage with fish and game staff or fish and game commissioners. We also assess the health and population status of big game herds to inform the season setting process. I'll go into that more in a moment. At the outset of the season setting process, we take those ideas we've collected over the last year or so and run them through several filters to compare them against such things as management priorities, compatibility with existing hunts, and information on herd health and hunter harvest. Ideas that achieve objectives become draft proposals that are then put out for public input. Proposals may be modified or dropped in response to input received from the public. Those remaining or modified proposals become final proposals that are then presented to the Fish and Game Commission at their March meeting. Fish and Game's management plans set the sideboards for season setting. The plans identify management priorities by species throughout the state. Season setting sets the specifics of those management objectives. These plans were developed by staff with substantial public input. We asked Idahoans what kinds of hunting opportunities they want to see and ideas for how to address issues. For example, how to balance a desire for trophy hunting opportunity, which means limiting harvest, with the opportunity to hunt every year in general seasons. Management plans contain data outlining what we know about deer and elk populations and deer and elk hunting in Idaho. These plans are also the place Fish and Game identifies management direction, both statewide and in specific areas like elk zones. These plans provide detail on topics such as deer and elk population objectives and damage control objectives, as well as social desires like hunt types and hunter opportunity. The plans also identify the strategies designed to address specific issues and to reach those objectives. The first three videos in the State of Deer and Elk series covered a lot of the biology and monitoring of deer and elk in Idaho. Season setting is one of the places we put those data to use. Deer and elk population surveys provide a check-in on the overall abundance and composition of populations. Survival monitoring tells us about current conditions and the effect they're having on deer and elk survival and how the previous year's fawns and calves are faring. Harvest data indicate the number of animals taken in each unit in specific hunts, and other important metrics like the total number of hunters in a particular unit or hunt. When all three data sources are analyzed together, we're able to get a pretty good picture of the trajectory of the population, the effect hunter harvest is having on that population, and how much and what kind of opportunity can be offered to hunters in the coming seasons. In addition to management plan sideboards and biological data, other factors affect the viability of an idea or lead to changing up an idea before it becomes a proposal, such as ensuring a hunt doesn't lead to additional wildlife conflicts like depredations, or it doesn't create potential conflicts with existing hunts, such as overlapping archery and rifle hunts, and whether the idea would result in a change that's enforceable. If an idea is compatible with all these filters, then it becomes a proposal. It's important to note that each proposal is trying to achieve something. That might be reducing tags to address deer elk populations that have declined or changed the area they're in during the hunting season. It might be adding additional hunter opportunity where growing deer or elk populations allow, or it might be ensuring deer and elk aren't causing depredation problems by using hunting as a management tool. And sometimes a proposal might be intended to meet multiple goals, such as providing additional hunter opportunity where increasing elk or deer populations are creating depredation concerns. There are several opportunities for public input on deer and elk seasons. Ideas can be brought to the department anytime. Season proposals are more structured, with a comment period in February of season setting years when fish and game regions host open houses and public meetings, and proposals and comment opportunities are posted on our website. And comments and ideas can be conveyed directly to commissioners. The Idaho Fish and Game Commission is responsible for administering fish and game policies, but they also serve as liaisons between the public and the department. Commissioner contact information is available on the Fish and Game website. In addition, each commission meeting includes a public hearing where anyone can present their ideas or concerns to the commission. We want to hear your opinion about managing Idaho's wildlife, including at the idea stage and at the proposal stage. Specific proposals are simply one way to accomplish a goal. We want to hear what the public has to say, including what it is about a proposal you like or don't like. Opposing a proposal is fine, but the reason we proposed it is still there. It is even more helpful to propose alternatives you like better that still accomplish the objectives the original proposal was intended to address. IDFG will present final recommendations to the Idaho Fish and Game Commission at their regular March meeting, when they will consider the proposals and take action to set big game seasons for the next 2 years. Lastly, I want to mention that season setting is far from the only time we solicit public input. Fish and Game conducts numerous surveys of Idaho hunters to assess hunter preferences and gauge hunter satisfaction. We also look for public input when developing or updating species management plans, which we do regularly. Lastly, we rely on hunters to help us gather information. Hunter reports are essentially a survey about where people are hunting and how many animals are harvested. We rely on hunters submitting accurate hunter reports each fall, whether or not you harvested an animal. That concludes my presentation. Thank you for watching and taking an interest in the management of Idaho's wildlife.